Cleveland is just 1-9 so far in December, but the last time Kyrie Irving and the Cavs were in Boston, Kyrie, with the time winding down late in the contest, made that spinning move in the paint with time running down, and the Cavs would go on to win, that being the game-winning bucket. Fast forward back to Wednesday night, and the results weren't the same early on for Kyrie. Rajon Rondo poking it away and getting the layup in the other end. Rondo, 12 points in the first quarter. It was a close game early on, though. Alonzo G picking off the Courtney Lee pass, an easy slam for G on the other end. Boston, though, led 27-25 after the first quarter. The Celtics building a lead in the second. Paul Pierce, as Rondo finds him wide open beyond the arc. Pierce, 3-for-3 from downtown in the first half. Then Kevin Garnett gets in on the act, layup and the foul. Three-point play is complete, and Boston led by 8 at halftime. In the third, well, Paul Pierce just kind of doing his thing. Fadeaway jumper, a slam right there. Rondo finds him again after penetrating into the paint. And then Pierce, another three. How about 17 points in the third for Paul Pierce as the Celtics led by 18 at that point. But here comes Kyrie. Rolls in a three right there. Then a jumper at the foul line is good. How about a drive from Kyrie? In traffic, gets that one on a friendly roll. Part of a 9-0 run for Cleveland. Irving, 15 points in the third, 22 in the ballgame. Cavs still on a run. That's Tyler Zeller. How about a 17-0 run for Cleveland to get them back in within two? Zeller had 20 after a made free throw. Celtics, though, respond. Rondo hits a key jumper. He had 20 points and 8 assists. And then the Celtics putting it away, and it's the truth. Spinning in the paint, gets it to go. Had 25 in the second half on 10 of 11 from the floor. Finished with 40, did Paul Pierce, as Boston snaps a three-game skid.